learning. I'm learning about prayer more every day. I've been on this journey this year of going to all of the different Narayas. And one thing that's happened is I've started waking up with the sunrise. And so I've had the blessing to take that time to work with prayer more, because there's this time when nobody else is awake and nothing's expected of me, and I can sit with myself and the rising sun and the oak trees outside of my house and pray. Pray for the people I love, pray for myself. Lately, I've been trying to pray for the people who I have trouble showing them that I love them because they annoy me or push my buttons or something. And that has been really beautiful because it's become so much easier to love them after praying for them every morning. Part of my prayer is that my ongoing prayer is that I remember how much a part of all of it I am, how much a part of the atoms in the chair that I'm sitting on sometimes when I pray, and how, you know, the electrons are moving in my body and the cells of my body, the atoms have bits of themselves moving into the chair. Just the possibility of all of us being so deeply interconnected. And that's what I pray about sometimes. It's been really beautiful to receive everybody's prayer on the Naraya prayer list. Sometimes I get them in the middle of work and I try to stop and create this space around me, this little bubble with all the craziness. I work at a community center, and so there are always people coming in and out. And take a moment to read those prayers and put those out to the world, and that always makes me so much more grounded in the livelihood work that I'm doing, to take a moment to connect in that way.